2,000 people. Wow. Let's not go ahead too far. to this group. Seems my bike repair yesterday sorted out the creek, which is nice. A bit quieter. Looks like the volcano's coming up. Thank you. Here goes the volcano. comes the first leaders downhill. So three, wow, going fast. Just relax. Got a big epic comp up next. So, no being stupid now. Now we've got the biggest two climbs coming. Seems to be calming down now. Everybody knows what's coming up. Not just the epic comp, but to the tower, which will definitely hurt. Save it for the Alpe if I've got anything left. This mic is working. new mic, should I say, is working better, and you can probably hear me being out of breath a bit better than before, and possibly speaking quickly. A climb proper. This is where we'll start seeing the pain show. So, taking it easy up here. Hopefully around a 27 minute pace for the climb. We'll see. Trons in front. To get that steeper section out of the way. Thank you. where the climb properly starts. When I did the Three Sisters on Friday, is it Friday? Yeah. I had 11 ant plus dropouts, which was really annoying. Stopped me in my tracks for anywhere between 2 and 5 seconds, which killing your momentum and building speed back up again meant I lost a lot of time. So far, I've not had a dropout yet. But undid all the connections and redid them again. Moved them away. Moved the Amp Plus connector directly under the Neo. So far, it's all good. Touch wood. Feeling reasonably comfortable. Heart rate's close to threshold. Threshold's about 178. My max is 191, which for a 55-year-old ain't too bad. Right there. This is a reasonable pace up here. This is where the fast starters begin to hurt a bit. Almost to the castle in the snow line now. Great. So guys, going up at 4.5 plus. Clearly, either super strong or forgetting they've got the Alpe to come. Nice hat. Castle and snow line. That white wire, hey. Hayden, while you're in there, can you pass me the mouse, please? Thank you. And while you're there, don't touch that white cable. Just that fan, just move it a little bit towards Daddy's head. No, twist it around so it's pointing at me. Move the whole thing. And just grab the base. No, that's it, and just turn it around a little bit. That's it, a bit more. Perfect. Cheers, mate. Whew. I think like a bit of fan tweaking mid-ride. Thanks for the ride on, mate. I hope you're in this race somewhere. Sorry, it's a Sportive, not a race, but we all know what it is. Why they don't just call it as such. Here's a mini review of High Fives energy drink, the one with 160 milligrams of caffeine in it. I normally use the High Five 4+1 energy drink, which I love and swear by. But when I was running out, I couldn't get any, so thought I'd try this energy plus 160 milligrams of caffeine. Now, I have to say, I don't get on with it. I used it on a couple of the evening races, and I could not sleep well the next night. It was horrendous. And I'm not entirely sure what benefit I got during the race. The races, should I say. It doesn't sit well in my stomach either. Obviously, that's personal, but I don't drink coffee at all, so I don't have any other caffeine supplements, so maybe just having that much caffeine is a little bit much. But as I say, it doesn't sit well, and it's makes it a real problem for me to sleep at night on that night. I had no choice to use it today because I still couldn't get what I want to use. And I bring this up because my stomach's just feeling a little bit queasy now, having almost finished a bottle of it. I think that's a personal taste one, that, and whether you can get on with the level of caffeine in it. Clearly I am taking it easy up here, otherwise I wouldn't be talking to you now. Which is reassuring. Got to go that stupid flat bit, which always winds me up. Right. Thank you. 4.8. There's some very strange people. Oh, interesting setups. Loads of people coming past me now. Not going to get sucked in though. Sure my fans aren't on me, right? Trace, could you just, before you sit down, that fan has just moved, can you just twist it so it's pointing straight at my head, please? This way. Yeah, thank you. There's the ram. Then the famous archway. How fast do we go up today? 26, 23 on Friday. Wow, quite a bit faster. Okay, 24, 52. Well, I hope I haven't blown it. Okay, this is where I really gotta take it steady. Just be calm. This will determine how or what's left of the Alpe. Okay. There's the leaders. Flying, and this is where we find a few of the daft people that have their trainers set up 100%. Trying to set up 50%. A, for stupid gradients like this, and B, because we've got a Neo with the downhill motor, it makes it a bit easier to stay with people on the downhill. Good for the Alpe. Never easy this bit. As you'd expect. Old debate, snot rocket on your training or not, I'm afraid I am a get on with it, aim for the mat, sort it out later. I cannot be bothered to fart around. Okay, now being a lightweight, I need to stay in a group going downhill. Otherwise, I go backwards very quickly. Okay, don't want to be at the front of it though. I have to say, it's always nice to see all these others coming up when you're going down. I wanted to do a 3:15 time. Now, pure guesswork, but I normally do in race conditions a 54-55 out. I'm expecting today clearly going to be quite a bit slower than that. I don't know, guessing maybe a 110. Now, I can't think how long it's going to take to get from the top of the Alpe to the finish, but guesstimating half an hour. It's 1:40 from the top of the Alp. So that would mean I need to start the Alp at 2:15, 1:45, 1:35. So I've got 25 minutes to get to the base of the Alp. To be on schedule, if that schedule's really realistic. So we will see. It looks like the schedule might be okay, but that's if it just goes straight down from here, straight to the start of the Alp. I'm assuming it does. Result. We shall see. Okay. So far, not been too bad. You stop leaving at the bloody front, come on. Guys, get in the front and give me some shelter. Thank you. Now, I just want to cruise to the bottom of the Alp without losing too many paces. Flurry there, just to see if we can catch this other group. Safety numbers. Still touch wood, no dropouts, so system's looking good. Now, Marcus, why wasn't this course the long double pointer? Anyway, like these blue flowers, a bit weird, but still. Excuse me. This is quite relaxing. Before the storm. Funny how my position, overall position, hasn't changed a lot since the start. Roughly been in the early 300s from the start. I think at one point it was 270 or something. Then I dropped back on the climb. I didn't want to push it. There again. Interesting to see just how much I die on the Alp. I have to say, it's nice riding the bike now without a creak. Slightly embarrassing. I thought it was a pedal, but I swapped the pedals out a week and a half ago and it was still there, so clearly not a pedal. So I figured it's bottom bracket, and let's face it, Canada was renowned for BB30s creaking. So I took it in yesterday morning with a desperate plea to please sort it out. Luckily, the mechanic in the shop that I go to is my old team's mechanic. So even though he was stacked out with jobs, he did it while I waited. And slightly embarrassing. Its bottom bracket was perfect. The crank had slightly come undone. So we cleaned it all out, tightened it up, and now no creaking. So nice. Got back yesterday and lubed up the chain. Ready for today's onslaught. Let's face it, even if I can get an extra watt out of lubing the chain, I'll take it. Now, what is everybody else's early morning regime when you've got a Sunday morning race, or any morning race, 9 o'clock race? I have to get up at about 6, which is annoying, but I need to get my breakfast and get my food in, so it's sorted before the race. Sorry, race. up at 6 this morning, having my breakfast, consisted of 3 boiled eggs, some ham, and a nice piece of granary toast, a couple of oranges and a banana, and a probiotic drink, and a pint of water. Seems to be drifting away in this bloody smoke, dust even. Up fairly early this morning. And fighting around getting the camera set up and get the position right. Trying to get the fans on and right. Clearly took some tweaking there. Mix up the drinks. Now, didn't have a warm up this morning. Well, should we say 5 minutes before the start? Figured I do not want to be on the bike too long. As some of you might be aware, I've got a issue with my right foot. Basically, well, I broke it badly about 30 years ago. Both the tib and the fib were completely smashed. Whole ankle was offset forwards and slightly to the side. And now consequently my right leg is around about 15 mil shorter than the other leg. And as I say, offset, which has caused number of issues in the 30 years since, but on the whole I managed to work it, mainly because I don't do long rides, but that 111, my foot was killing me because it's all the pressure of constant pressure from a virtual race was just on my right side of it. So I had to have a, I'm gonna shut up now. Right, so here we go. Out. Now, let's take it easy. Too easy to get sucked into this bit and go hard from the off. I'm 20 though. That's way in advance of what I was expecting. Plan is to take this easy, hopefully pick people off at the top that started too hard, but we shall see. Normally, at this stage, I'll be up in the 270, 280 watts. So going 210, I am definitely taking it easy. Riding my own ride, not following others. The Alpe is too big to ride at other people's pace. This guy in front's got orange legs. First couple of men's always feel like the longest ones. Green trine is bright. 15. This guy's going up without pedaling. How's that work? Oh. new shoe, wedge in the shoe, doesn't seem to have done anything. Just on 2 hours. Hey, Dan, can you find Daddy's slippers? You know, the sandals. Daddy just needs the right hand slap sandal. Can't remember whether it's in the lounge or dining room.
Thank you.
Try upstairs in the bedroom then.
What?
Our bedroom. Over by the window, maybe. Oh, just the right hand one, mate. That one. No, that's the left. That one, yeah. Cheers. Okay. My foot is literally killing me. At this stage, the only option I've found is to put a normal summer sandal on, which it's not an easy thing to pedal in, but it gives me about an extra half an hour. I don't know whether I'll be able to finish. Okay, so now I'm in normal summer sandal on my right foot and cycling shoe on the left. So not the easiest thing to ride in, as you would expect, but a lot less painful for about half an hour usually. Hopefully we'll get the out done, and if I'm lucky, the downhill will give my foot a chance to just recover enough to let me finish this thing. But that's debatable. Right now, I'm just trying to finish this thing, which is irritating. Because the way it was going, I was thinking I was going to do a half decent time for me anyway. Yeah, I don't know. Dropping positions out of the fist, but honestly right now, I don't care. Even though I'm riding comfortably, I don't want to push anything in case my right foot hurts so much. I have to stop, which probably will wind up happening, but I'd really like to see if I can finish this as opposed to stopping it. Thank you. 4. Well, mate, how are you doing?
What place are you in?
Oh, 356. Mm-hmm. 356 out of 2,717.
Is that good?
It's okay. Yeah, it's okay. But it's a really long race, mate.
Why? If I was on there, I'd be like bending fast.
Would you?
Yeah, we'd probably like that, fifth.
Yeah, you'd be fifth, would you? Well, you're gonna have to get you on here then and see you go. Get mummy on here and see how she goes. That's been comfortable throughout. Am I losing places yet? Not too I care. Nah. This is about finishing this thing, not places. Thing is, I've got no idea where all these guys or what category these guys are around me. I have it in my head, obviously, that they're all A riders, so I don't care, but more than likely there's a load of B's and C's and maybe even some D's in it, so probably good that I don't know, because that would spur me on to go faster. But I'm more inclined to try and finish this at a slower pace. Well, at least we are getting close to the top now. I'm really hopeful that if I get to the top, my foot can recover a bit on the downhill. At least enough to allow me to finish this. Ooh. it's so crazy, it's ridiculous. Thank you. Bloody hell. I wasn't expecting that. Still 5 minutes, might be minutes off my race. Pace, considering what we've done first, I'm happy lily with that. Now, I need to try and take it easy and try and relax my right foot. Until I can finish this thing. 2:20. Alright, I'm kind of working on a theory of 10 minutes to the bottom, half an hour to the finish, which would be 3 hours. So, that would be a much better time than I was expecting. But, can my right foot continue for 40 minutes in a summer sandal? Need to get on a downhill so I can just relax a bit. Ooh. Okay. No pressure on my right foot. So basically I'm swiping one leg down in the hope it releases the pressure on my foot enough to get me to finish. Okay.
Sunday.
very civilized. Nice and relaxing. Fair play to everybody. That's where we are going up at the moment, because you've got a lot longer to go, and man, I would not like to be doing a climb at the sort of length of time you guys are taking. So hats off to you. I can't buy for long periods. Trace, I don't suppose you could fill my bottle with water, please, could you? That's what's having a supportive wife. Cyclists have a supportive wife, otherwise we wouldn't be able to do what we do. At the time that we do. Thank you, Trace.
Yeah.
Exactly. I was figuring on top 700 out of 3,000 that I'd enter. So 380 off at the moment. Frankly, I'm well happy with that. I'm sure I won't finish there, but it's a lot better than I was expecting. If we're able to get to the finish in the next half an hour, which I'm not sure whether we can or not, sub 3 hour time would be much better than I expected. So, okay. Looks like we all have the same idea of just taking this downhill to relax. It's about 10 seconds, so I suspect we'll hang down and let them come up, and then hopefully we'll have a big enough group to get to the finish. Thank you. in this from here. Back. So this is a new experience. Thank you. Thank you. 76-16. Wow. Seen anybody on that. Drop down from the Alp just gave my right foot enough chance to relax a bit, so I was able to push on that last flat section. So I'm well happy, but still annoyed that I had to rip my shoe off and ride in a summer sandal for 45 minutes of that race. Get through it. Still, I did. Okay, I'm paused. So good. Okay. cops are going to see them after me. Take me easy.